If you have already subscribed, then click the bell icon to get instant notifications when I put a new video up. Do it now. Yo, what's up guys, I am Rob, welcome to my channel. So today's DIY project is super interesting because we will be taking trash and we'll transform it into something that looks super expensive, something that you would buy off a store. But before we talk about that, I want to make a request. You see that subscribe button? Please click on that and subscribe to my channel. I would really appreciate it. Guys, I love it that we are growing like this. Our family has grown so big. We are so close to our 1 million mark. I love that now we have a community of artists that is so huge. So what you can do is you can help me cross the milestone quicker. So please subscribe. If you've already subscribed, then please get your friends or family to subscribe so that we reach our 1 million mark soon. Also, you can click on the bell notifications icon so you're updated whenever we put a cool DIY video up. All right, so let's get to today's DIY. So today we are going to do embossing on a soda can. Now a soda can or a soft drink can is a freely available material. I'm sure you guys consume soft drinks every day or often. So next time you're having a drink, save the can, get it home because you can recycle it and make something cool with it. And if you have one at home, then you're good to go. Let's get started. So get ready, it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. So do you want to see what we're going to convert our soda can into? Get ready. Look at that. Isn't that amazing? I think it looks really nice. So this is your ordinary soda can or a soft drink can. I just drew a gecko on that, did some embossing to give it a 3D look, and then I pasted it onto a rock like this. And you can see it looks like a nice metal embossed decor item. Like I said, looks like something you would buy from a store. And now you can use this as a decor piece on your center table, on your shelf, or just keep it in your room. Looks pretty nice. So now I'm going to show you guys how you can make something like this. So as you can see, this one is a plain solid piece. There aren't any designs or patterns on this. So this one was pretty simple. I just drew the gecko shape onto my soda can, and then I basically did some embossing to make this whole shape a little prominent and 3D. But when you have more details on it or patterns on it, then you have to take individual pieces and emboss them to give a nice texture. And that's exactly what we are going to do. We are going to make a dragonfly. So you can see it has a lot of patterns, a lot of different shapes. And now I'm going to show you guys how you can create something really beautiful looking using this embossing technique. So you can do either design, either something that is detailed or something that is flat. This one is easy. So we are going to do a little more challenging one. So let's get started. All right, so now we are going to transfer this nice detailed dragonfly design onto our surface. And our surface here is this empty soda can that I cut open and I flattened it. This is aluminum sheet. All your soft drink cans are made out of aluminum. So now we're going to use this and we are going to do the embossing on this. So instead of the printed side, I am going to use this clean surface. So first what we are going to do is we are going to paste a dragonfly onto the metal sheet here, the aluminum sheet. For that, I'm using transparent sticky tape. Now to stick it in place, instead of putting tape only on the edges, I am going to cover the whole surface or the whole paper, the sheet, with a transparent sticky tape because I am going to use the embossing tools and I will go over these lines and I'll apply pressure to make dents in our aluminum metal sheet. Some of the tools are slightly sharp so you can cut through the paper. So if you have a layer of tape, that gives protection to the paper. Okay, so let's stick this in place. All Alright, so we are done with the layer of tape. As you can see, now it's nice and glossy. So there is a protective layer on top of this. And now we'll take our embossing tools and start embossing. So right here are my embossing tools. So you can see they have a metal tip. They come in different sizes. This one is pretty small and sharp. This one is pretty big to cover bigger surfaces. So basically you can do a lot of detailing with this. So first I'm going to take this fine tip and start doing the outline of my design. But before I start doing that, I will take this foam sheet and I'll place this under my design. Now what this does is, when I'm applying pressure to create dents, because the surface below is soft, the dents form very easily. If you're doing this on a hard surface, then forming these dents becomes difficult. And for embossing, all you're doing is you're pressing the metal sheet so that it protrudes from the other side. So if you have a softer surface, then it works better. See, if I press this, you can see this is going in like that other side. So what we're doing is we are creating a dent or a protrusion on the other side. So like that, with little pressure, just go over all the lines. Once your lines are nice and sharp, then you can start embossing the areas or the surface in the middle. So while you're outlining the form, also keep checking. So flip it and check the other side. So here you can see my dragonfly is nicely transferred onto the aluminum sheet. So now I can remove this paper reference. So let's remove this. The paper reference is gone and you can see we have the dragonfly design on our aluminum sheet. Now what we need to do is we need to follow this new outline that we have and use our bigger tools, these fatter ends, and we will emboss our design. But now that we have this outline, we will flip it and apply pressure on the other side because we want the design to be embossed on this clean surface. If I press it down here, then again, I'll have the embossing effect on this side. And because there is a soft ring on this side, it will not look that great. So instead of embossing it from this side, we will flip it and we'll do it on this side. So you can see our outline is there. I'll take it section by section. I'll do the same thing using my tool. I'll apply pressure and emboss this. So let's do it. Alright, looks like we are done. So you can see we have quite deep grooves here or dents here. So what I did is I used my fatter tools to make these bigger depressions, and then I used my thinner tool, these thinner ends, to make the lines or corners sharper. With just these three tools, you can see our dragonfly embossed design is ready. Looks nice, looks pretty clean. So this is done. Now our next step is we have to cut it out cleanly and then we will stick this onto a rock. Now if you want, you can use it as is, just cut a bigger piece out and you can frame it, or you can put it up on the wall, stick it on your notebook or diary, whatever. But I am planning to make this into a decor item. So I'm going to cut it out cleanly and then stick it onto that rock. So let's do that. Now I'm using scissors to cut this. Aluminum sheet that they use in soda cans is pretty thin and flimsy. So you can very easily cut it using scissors. Just be extra careful. One, you don't want to damage or cut through your design. Two, you have to be extra careful because when you're cutting it, the edge edges are pretty sharp, so just be slightly careful that you don't hurt yourself. There you go, you can see I have cut this out cleanly. Looks nice. And now we will get our big rock and we will stick this on that. Ooh, it's alive. And there you go. I have this nice big rock from my garden. Look at that. You can see this has a big enough surface where I can stick the dragonfly. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to figure out in which place the dragonfly looks the best. So I'll take a corner where there is a slight bend so that it looks like it's covering the surface, and then I'll stick it. I think I'm very happy with this placement, also because the way the rock is placed, it's balancing nicely in this corner. So I'm going to stick it right here. Let's turn this. Let's apply some glue in the middle. So while you're applying the hot glue, you'll have to keep in mind that you'll have to apply quite a bit because there are dents here or grooves here. So you have to fill in the whole dent or groove and also have enough so that it sticks to the surface. Now let's press it down. All right, so you can see it sticks really nicely with the hot glue, and I've pressed it down along the shape or the surface of the rock. So the body is done. Now very carefully, I'll apply glue on the inside right here of the wings and then press them down so that this becomes nice and flush with the shape or the surface of the rock. Okay, let's do it. All right, looks like we are done. Look at that. Let's place this somewhere. Isn't that a great recycling technique? I think it's fantastic because you're taking something that is waste or trash and you're converting it into something that looks spectacular. And because it's so simple and inexpensive, I really, really like it. I hope you guys also enjoyed watching this video and found this tutorial helpful. And if you did, then please don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up, like it and share it with your friends. Also subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I'll keep reminding you. If you have, then you can also subscribe to my other channel, Robin the Hood, where I put up vlogs. Also, if you're making this, then don't forget to click pictures and share them with me on my Instagram handles right here. Here are my links. Please tag me. Also in the comments below, let me know what you thought of this technique, whether you're going to try it or not, or if you want me to try something different, you can suggest down below. All right, that's the end of the video. I'll see you guys in my next one. Until then, like I always say, do good and be good. Peace.